Hey everyone, today Scorcher Toys at AnyMoon.com is reviewing Sentinel's Riobot Legioss toy, released in June 2020 for 25,000 yen, which for those of you keeping tally of such things is 3,800 yen less than the Evolution toy Legioss. Now I call it a Legioss because I think that's how English speakers would pronounce it, but you may prefer Legioss, Legioss, or Alpha Fighter. Whatever the term, you can find these toys and support this channel by clicking the link in the comment below to head to Big Bad Toy Store. This version is sold out, but rumor has it we'll be getting more variants and maybe a reissue, so keep an eye out for more listings. This toy comes in a box that is very similar to the Riobot Ride Armor toys in both dimensions and form, with Mercy Rabbit again providing slick visuals. Inside, you'll find a plastic tray that includes a toy and a little stick Bernard, a VR-52F Ride Armor in bike mode and a little stand to keep it upright, a pair of weapon rails, the gun, a fighter mode display stand adapter. There are also intake covers pre-installed but may have popped free. If it sounds like something is loose in there, hopefully that's your culprit. In the next tray, you'll also find the display stand base, the arm, the base of the arm, and a diver and soldier mode connector. Below it all, you'll find instructions, and you can find a full scan of those instructions on AnyMoon.com. The included pilot figure doesn't have much in the way of paint apps, but it does have a lot of articulation for something so small. Head's a ball joint, it can look straight up. You do also have the ability to turn left and right. The arms are ball joints that come off very easily. So you're not gonna play with this toy, with the pilot figure, but you can get it in the pose you want and then leave it alone. There's no waist twist, but there is a nice pivot at the waist. Ball jointed hips and knees round out articulation there. You can get him into a riding position and plop him down on the bike and get those fists. Now his fists aren't gonna connect to any handlebars or anything like that. But there you go, you can get him on the bike. Let's bend those knees a little, make it look somewhat natural. You would do a much better job because you wouldn't be filming yourself while you do this, but there you go, rides just fine. And we can also take him and put him into the cockpit. While the paint apps overall are really good on this toy, like those little no step signs we have behind the cockpit, the cockpit itself is a little drab, not a lot going on in there, but we can open the canopy and we can slide our pilot figure's feet in and then coax him into the seat like so. And then we can just bring that canopy down. And then we have that full-sized pilot figure sitting comfortably in the cockpit. The toy does come with a gun. To use the gun in fighter mode, you're gonna remove the magazine. Now with all the other crazy engineering going on in this toy, it would have been cool if the magazine could pivot or something instead of needing to be removed entirely. Unlike some other Legioss guns, you can't pivot the grip back or adjust the stock. It just kind of is what it is. We can then take the hardpoint rails that are included and they just slide into position on the gun. And then you can flip your toy over and install that gun on the hardpoint underneath the wing. So there you can see it. This is a little easier to do when you don't have the landing gear open. So we can close this door a little bit here. Get that lined up and underneath. There you go. So I got it underneath that landing gear door to make it work. And there you go. Now you've got the gun installed in fighter mode. Also included is this central missile bay. It comes already pre-installed on the toy. If you've taken it out and you want to install it, because in the show it's never really on there, there are little slots in the sides of either arm. And there are little pegs on the side of either side of the missile bay. And so we can just lift that up, create some room, push this in, and then peg it into position, and then close that arm up. And everything should line up just right. We'll peg the arm back in from behind here. Let's find that little spot. There it goes. And there you have the missile bay on. And what we can also do is remove our gun from its spot on the side here. And we would take off this little hard point rail, which is on there very stiffly. And then we can take that bottom where we remove the magazine and plug the gun in to that central missile bay. So you could stow the gun that way too. Now I do have one little QC issue. This fin here has a tendency to want to go straight, so I really have to massage it to just the right angle. So the toy is beautiful, great paint throughout, detail work up the top, clear plastic inserts on the nose and at the knees. One thing that is another QC issue though, while we're looking at all the nice gold trim on the back, is this flap right here. Barely connects at all. It is definitely loose and floppy. So that is one big issue that we'll hope to see fixed on future variants and any reissues that might come our way. The toy does have integrated landing gear, but they are not the most user-friendly, mostly due to stiffness issues. So you can see you gotta get a fingernail in off to the side here to open up this door here. I'm using a little cell phone repair tool. And then there's a front door with a little wiggle jiggle you can get out, and a front landing gear that comes out. Now, it's really stiff in the front, but you can bring it all the way forward and it'll actually lock into position. And then you can tilt this front portion back to make it look like it does in all the line art, which is pretty cool. And then moving our attention to the back of the toy, we have this little door right here, which we can pull open, and it's got a little extension that you can see there. So it hides the hinge and then pulls out. So we can do that. And then we can pull this door out like so. And there is the rear landing gear, very well tucked in there. Now you're supposed to be able to fish a fingernail onto this little nub right here, but it's very stiff. So what I've been doing is grabbing needle nose pliers. So good luck, you might want to do the same thing. Now the other thing that's weird about this is that they come out at an angle. So early users having issues potentially breaking their landing gear, and it's because you're used to bringing things straight back. These ones come down and out like so. Once they're out, you twist the gear like so to get it nice and straight, and it'll stay in that locked back position so you can actually roll your toy around. Nice rubber tires on spinning wheels. The construction of this is mostly plastic, which is another thing that's causing those problems with people breaking the landing gear. There is some metal in this toy. This part is plastic. Be careful as you pull it out. Here the toy is sitting on those landing gear, and you can see tons of clearance, rolls just fine, no landing gear collapsing, really high marks. Most toys, most Legioss toys, have that white hump right on the ground or just above it, not this toy. You can also remove that center missile pod, put on one of these little hardpoint rails, and you can connect the missile pod underneath the wing. If you want to go, I don't know anyone that would actually do this, but if you wanted to go that route, you have that option also. Okay, you got your landing gear up, you're whooshing the toy around, and I just want to demonstrate this thing whooshes just fine, and you can hold this toy from pretty much any area, and it doesn't feel like it's a wet noodle in the middle, which again, doesn't seem like high praise, but when you consider all the previous Legioss toys we had, this thing is special. It feels great. Now turning the toy over, there has been a common production issue where these pieces here are not rotated in the right direction. Do not freak out about this. Transform your toy into soldier mode. You can rotate that part around in soldier mode without too big of an issue. So don't try to like disassemble the screw or anything. Try just transforming the toy. You should be okay. Now, once you are in fighter mode with the landing gear up, you might decide that it's time to use your display stand. To do that, you're going to pop off this VTOL vent, which might be a little easier said than done, which is a good thing. So that comes off, and then you can see there's a little hole below. The fighter mode adapter looks like the boom of a tread, which is pretty cool, maybe. Hopefully some foreshadowing. This peg may be someday used for a tread. While we're talking about the tread, there's also a little slot in the foot. So it seems to be a window open here for a potential tread someday. Now the back of the adapter slides into the feet. The front of the adapter comes forward and grabs that peg. It's all a very tight, kind of uncomfortable fit, to be perfectly honest with you. And there it goes. Once it's on there, you just peg it in to the arm. Let's get it into a somewhat natural pose. Now you can see there are some stiffness issues here, but there's also a Phillips head there that I might be able to tighten. And there you go. Now you have the toy on the display stand, and since it connects via a peg, we can angle it in either direction, pivot it up and down. So there you go. That is another option with this toy. Now, you might have been thinking that for roughly $250 US, you'd be getting a toy similar in size to the old Gakken 135, but that is not the case. At 22 centimeters long in fighter mode, this toy is really close to a true 148 scale, which is more like the size of the CMs or Toynami figures. While Toynami used more metal than the toy's joints or quality of plastic could handle, Sentinel has limited metal to internal structures, making for a better overall experience. Ignoring the size differences, this is the first Legioss toy that has the right shape in fighter mode. It's not perfect, there's a gap before the heels, tiny gaps next to the cockpit, and you can get a peek of the shoulder sensor, but these are nitpicks in comparison to the egregious sins of the CMs or Toynami toys. Flipping the toys over, the Sentinel is the only toy that doesn't look like a disaster. Diver mode is sexy, and there's a lot of really cool engineering that gets you here, so do check out my separate transformation guide. This sensor array is integrated. One of the complaints that I've seen out there is that it doesn't sit as flat as you would like it to. Now, it is on a pretty stiff hinge, so you can get it flat, but when you handle it, you might knock it again, so that's not ideal. The worst issue with this toy that exposes itself when you get to diver mode, and hopefully this is just a first run issue, is that the shoulders are incredibly stiff to the point where some people thought they could not even rotate at all. You can force them to rotate, as I have done on this side. They're supposed to spin all the way around. I suspect what happened was Sentinel really wanted to make sure that you'd be able to hold the gun out straight like you can here, but they overdid it. And so the joint is so stiff, it's really worrisome that using it is gonna break something. And that is made more true by the fact that the housing on the top of the shoulder just tabs on. You can do a lot of stuff with this housing. And so if you're really trying to force it, it feels like you'll break the tabs on the housing before you'll get that joint to rotate, which is very problematic. Another quirk of the design is that the sides of the intakes pivot around to get underneath the intakes, and that creates the room for the sides of the wings here. So that could cause a couple issues. First, visually, some people don't like that look, but now in diver mode, the nose is generally sloped down and that would conceal it. The other thing is a little less clearance in the bottom for the knees. Now you do have the ability to take your knee and bring it to a lower position, but I haven't really found that that helps at all. So choose, you have the option. If you think it might help you out, go ahead and give it a try. Another thing we've seen is that the ankles are metal and they go into a metal ball joint, but that can be just a little bit loose. So sometimes you'll have your toy in a pose that puts a little too much weight in one direction and the ankle doesn't hold it stiff enough. For the most part, they're okay. They're not like super loose or anything like that. And they're actually a really cool design. You can pivot the foot towards one side of the housing or the other, which is a cool thing to be able to do. You can twist the foot and you could bring the toe way up or the heel way back. So all very good things there. A lot of articulation. Again, too bad that the shoulder joints are so stiff, because otherwise this thing is a ton of fun to handle. And if you're having some issues getting it in just the right pose on the ground, we have that display stand, so let's check that out. So here I am ripping off the classic Gearwalk pose from Macross on the diver mode toy. I've got it connected to the display stand via this hole in the back of the toy right there. And I hope someday there's a tread that connects there, because it's a very solid connection. All we've done here is put this piece on top of the display stand arm, and that's the same adapter we will use for soldier mode. At about 16.5 centimeters tall, this toy equates to 153 scale in soldier mode, but I'm gonna call it close enough. Both the CMs and Toynami toys are a little larger. The big brothers of the group certainly tower over this figure, but they don't look better doing it. If you're a stickler for perfect transformation, you may not want to use the intake fan covers. You don't absolutely have to. Here you can see what it looks like if you're not using them. They just peg into position and then you push down a little bit and it should stay there. Now, one of my gripes would be it doesn't stay in there quite as well as I would like. I can bump it free. So hopefully on future editions, they stiffen that up a little bit. You also get all of the missiles. You got three bays in the legs, two in the forearms, one on the shoulder. The shoulder one has a extending hinge. So there you can see the hinge right there opens up. That's what those missiles look like. That's what these missiles look like. That's what these missiles look like. I would like them all to be uniform, but at this scale, I'll let them have a little artistic license in that regard. This is the first Legioss toy I think I've ever had with the integrated missile bays and all of them working like they're supposed to. So all of these doors open and close just fine. Now this bottom door here does not have a little fingernail slot. So what you can do to cheat is get a little clear piece of plastic and that will help you get the torque you need to open that up. I do have one bay over on this side that has a little bit of gap. It's not sitting quite flush. There's just a little flashing in there. I could fix that with an X-Acto knife in a couple seconds. So there you go, all of the bays, and they work well. Transformation to soldier mode is unlike any Legioss toy you've previously owned. And one of the effects of that unique transformation is that it puts the cockpit directly underneath the head in soldier mode. So here we have this head. The head is on a ball joint. It can spin. It can look in either direction. It can tilt. It's all good. And it's not stuck in between the intakes like we see on some not nearly as good Legioss toys. And we can take this head and we can bring it forward and boom, right there is your pilot. He's doing the piloting. It's pretty sweet. Also, we can take this piece back here and we can shimmy that back. And then you can slide the canopy back. And it's very stiff when the toy is new, but you can slide that back. And once it is back, you can use your fingernail to open up that canopy. And now you can access the pilot figure. You can have him coming in and out, doing some cool poses where he's standing right next to it. So all good stuff there. Really cool feature of this toy. I know heroic pelvic thrusts are all the rage. So here is my Legioss toy doing the heroic look at my crotch move. So it can do it and that is cool. Maybe not the fact that that's a big trend, but the fact that it can do it is pretty cool. We've seen what the head can do from an articulation standpoint. We've seen that this very intricate shoulder here is a little stiff on this first release. Hopefully they fix that on later releases. There is the hinge though that lets you bring the arm up and away, and it does pivot back because part of transformation there, and it pivots at the end so you can bring the arm forward like so or back. All good stuff. Rotation point below the shoulder, above the bicep there. There is the elbow. Now if you are going to have your toy with the forearms like so, the elbow is going to be pretty limited on you, but you have another rotation point below the elbow that then lets you get more than 90 degrees of articulation. Now, unfortunately, it's not super crazy. You can't go up and touch your shoulders or anything. You can just get about that far. Moving down, we have the ball jointed hands. The thumb is on its own ball joint. You have a trigger finger, and then these three fingers also pivot together. Going down, we have that waist, which is great, and the pivot that's allowing that crotch to jut forward right now. You have what are basically simulated ball joints in the hips, which are pretty cool. They allow the hips to flare out like so. There's a little swivel there. You can pivot them out also like so and get a good A stance going, which is good, pretty aggressive. And then they are sleeves, so it can rotate all the way up and back until it hits the wing in the back or comes forward and hits the chest. So great articulation there. Also, these hips are super stiff. So while the ankles might be a little bit loose, you're not going to have any problems at the hip, which is great. If this were a Macross toy, I'd call this a Garawok joint, but you have a little pivot right above the knee. And then you have the knee itself, which is very stiff, and can go to, looks like almost exactly 9 degrees, hair above 90 degrees. Very stiff joint. It's going to hold the pose. You're going to swivel out at the hip. You don't swivel out at the knee. There's no swivel there. And then you've already seen how great those ball jointed ankles are and all the things they let you do. This toy is so much fun to pose and it looks so good doing it. You're going to have yourself a whole lot of fun. And of course, we still have that display stand. So if you're having a hard time getting the perfect pose, you can always elevate the toy, not worry about your center of gravity, and do pretty much whatever you want because this toy is so well articulated. I've gone ahead and thrown that missile pod on the back. Unlike Aoshima toys, maybe Evolution toy as well, you can't pivot that missile pod around to face forward on this. It's just gonna hide behind the shoulder at all times. And as far as I'm concerned, that is perfectly fine. Like Sentinel's ride armors, this toy is a modern reinterpretation of the design, but it's very similar to the original, so it remains an excellent likeness of the line art in any mode. There were several unfortunate tolerance issues on this first release, but all of them seem very easily addressed, so I'm optimistic that future reissues and variants will deliver on the promise of this toy. The crazy thing is, even with the shortcomings on this first release, it is still easily the best Legioss toy we have ever gotten, and I would much rather own one of these than all of my Toynami, Aoshima, or CM's offerings. If you're a fan of transforming toys, keep an eye out for pre-orders of other variants and reissues. Check out anymoon.com for my full article, subscribe, and thanks for watching.